Welcome back to Map of the Week. I'm Nate Odie. I'm an associate in the Harvard Department of Philosophy and lead instructor for Thinker Analytics. And this is the show where we break down the top arguments on both sides of issues in the news. And one issue that's been in the news a lot lately is whether America can survive the election in 2024 or whether we're headed towards a sort of civil war. There's actually been a lot of legitimate articles being written in the Washington Post, New York Times, Atlantic. People are really worried about the state of democracy in this country. And actually, the University of Virginia released some poll results recently that 52% of Trump voters and 41% of Biden voters strongly or somewhat agree that it's time to split the country. So this is pretty alarming, and a lot of people are covering it. So I just wanted to lay out for you guys the top arguments on both sides. And I'm actually going to start with the side that American democracy will not survive 2024. And the key argument here that a lot of people are talking about comes from an article in the Washington Post, in which it was argued that, well, really the issue is Trump, right? So Donald Trump will most likely be the Republican candidate for president in 2024, and that this is a threat to American democracy. So there's a lot of reason to think that Trump has already captured a lot of the Republican Party. And the argument is that he actually represents a national cult of personality. He's incredibly popular among Republicans, and it seems that there's really nothing that can be done to damage his reputation. He didn't achieve a lot of the things that he said he would in office, and he has been known to lie constantly. He's been impeached twice. He incited the January 6th Capitol insurrection, and yet his followers still love him. And so the claim is that this is really bad for democracy. And there's a further claim that because Trump is going to be the candidate for the Republican Party in 2024, this is bad for the election process because Trump has already possibly permanently damaged the election process, what many people have called a constitutional crisis. In particular, Trump incited the riot that happened on January 6th at the Capitol based on the things he said that morning. And a lot of local election leaders, local election officials are worried about this. So that's the worries that Trump's candidacy poses a serious problem for America. Now, even if you don't buy that, you might also still be just really concerned about democracy in America because we're a highly polarized society. And there's some data on this that's pretty alarming. Besides what I already mentioned about people agreeing that it's time to split the country, there's a sort of extreme negative polarization, meaning that Trump voters don't see any difference between Democrats and socialists, and Biden voters see little difference between Republicans and fascists. And it's just generally been observed by a lot of different polling organizations that Americans increasingly dislike and distrust members of the other party and see them in really negative terms. And so you might just worry that polarization is really bad for democratic culture, even if you're not concerned about Trump in particular. Okay, so that's all the bad news. In good news, you might think American democracy can survive 2024. One reason to think that is that the process of transferring power peacefully, which is such a hallmark of democracy, is still very much intact. And despite Trump's fraudulent claims of election fraud in the last election, none of the election officials or Supreme Court, you know, justices or any justices for that matter, took any of those claims seriously because they were false. And Biden was inaugurated president without any interruption. The military is importantly still a very firmly bipartisan institution, and it's very unlikely that the military will be used in any kind of coup, which is, you know, good. The Constitution seems to be relatively intact, and it is designed to sort of balance power among the different groups of government and to kind of limit authoritarianism. And finally, that American democracy has successfully faced many significant challenges in the past, including an actual civil war and the Great Depression and many other threats, both internally and from outside of us. So we are a resilient country, and I do think there's reason to be hopeful, but there's some things to be concerned about over here. So one question for you guys to think about is whether you trust the government to carry out a secure and fair election. And another good question might be, how would you compare the US to other countries, both now and throughout world history? What's a fair comparison to other democracies or democracies that were in trouble? And what lessons might we learn from history? So you guys can leave me in the comments whether you think we'll survive 2024, and I look forward to catching you next time.